welcome back to the making of The Quest for the Eye. It's a very quick little update just to show you what I've been doing. As you can see, I've done more of the layout of the village and things. And also I've added this mannequin here. Now eventually this will be replaced by the first enemy that you're going to encounter, which is going to be like a skeletal warrior type thing over here that you're going to need to fight. So at the moment, all it does is it will follow you and will kind of do an attack. So as you can see, we've still got your stamina and things, and we can't hit it or damage it in any way, which hopefully I can do that at some point. But you can see like that red bar above its head, that's going to be its health. So if I go in front of it, you'll see it's going to start running towards me. If I stop running, it will start hitting me. As soon as I'm out of sight, it will stop chasing me. So basically, you can kind of evade it. Also, I want to show you this very quickly. I've also done a little bit on the doors. The door's now open. So you just press F. I've put a little bit of lighting in here and also over in the chapel. So some of these things don't have it on yet. But as you can see, this is where you're going to start in here. You come out into the world. There's our enemy, which will be over there eventually. So there is a specific, he can't come out of that area at the moment. So as you can see, it's looking pretty good so far. And obviously we can sprint. We can also jump. Health will be next. Let's make our way over to the chapel. Quite a long way. And there will be NPCs and things running around here eventually. And there will be more stuff put in. But you can just see that it's come along rather nicely. The layout is good as well. I may move that building, that house, over a little bit. Because essentially what I want is kind of a clear line of sight from there. So we've not seen any paths or anything just yet. Getting close to the chapel now. So this is where you're going to have to make your way all the way over here. But you will, this axe that we're carrying at the moment, you will have to find that before you can come over here. So there'll be a little quest when you come out of the house to go and find a weapon, which would be either this axe or something or other. So you can come over here and meet the guards that will be outside here eventually. So there will be a couple of guards here and there. It's mostly like the townspeople, like the town watch, essentially. So there will be like a barricade at these gates that you can see in the distance there. So as we get a bit closer, I'll show you. Hopefully I've remembered to enable things on here. So here there will be a couple of guards, barricade, and they will tell you to go in here. So you have to come into here. Let's do it lit so you can see. So you come into here, fight a couple of the skeletons, and eventually you'll be able to make your way in here. So these doors won't open until you've killed all the mobs around here. So there will be like a little mini boss. But since it's level one, it's not going to be too bad of a boss. And then you can come in here. And this is where the monks are going to be hiding that you rescue. Their thank you. And then that's it. You can get their reward, whatever that reward's going to be. I'm not sure yet. And then you can make your way out here. And now that's that done. Then you can embark on your next quest, which will be leading out of the town. So out here into the main world. You've got to go and find the wizard next after that. That's kind of like your main quest, and try and find out why you're here. So the kind of the storyline to this, which I can now reveal, is essentially you've been teleported to this world somehow. You don't know how. You've woke up like over there, and you meet your first NPC, which will be the character Zerv. Or Zerg, one of the two. I'm not quite sure who yet. Probably Zerg. Because it's kind of his house, so that would make more sense that you'd meet him. But once you've met with that main character, he'll give you the quest to go and find Balpazard, the wizard. But as soon as you come out the door, you're going to be approached by another NPC, Town Guard. And that Town Guard is going to ask you to help them. Because eventually, so if you do go over to the exit prematurely, there will be guards. And they say, we cannot let you come out of the area until you've, you know, they just say that you can't go out. So you kind of have to go and do that first. And once you've done that over there, then you can go out. But you can explore. And there will be various things to pick up. Most notably, these apples. So they will come in very useful later on. And obviously, you've got to find the axe as well. So it'll be here somewhere. You have to find that nice weapon, and then you can go and kill the skeletons over here. And the mini-boss. Save the monks. Everyone's happy. Then you can go out there. Or you can come over there. In this way, maybe open as well to the beach. I'm still not sure what to do with the beach area just yet. But once I've worked out what I'm doing there, then I can go ahead and implement that section. But I want to get this sorted first. I want to get all the coding and things done before we progress any further in the storyline. But yeah, so that's it for now. Everything's still here and in progress and that. I'm just going to continue working on the NPC and the enemy here. And once I've figured out how to get it to do your damage and how it can take damage, then I can replace the mesh with the skeleton I've been working on in Blender, which is available to see on my Crimson Studio Facebook page. So you can have a look at that. The link will probably be in the description for that. So yeah, so that's it. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you in the next video, whenever that will be. Goodbye for now.